Hi, everybody. My name is Simon Rosenberg, and I took my opportunity for my capstone internship to look more at the skateboarding and snowboarding industry. So if you know anything about me, you know that skateboarding and snowboarding are huge parts of my life, and they have been for a while. Here's me at age 7, my first skateboard, and then me at age 12, my first snowboard competition. So I really took this opportunity to look behind the curtain and step away from the consumer side of both industries and look more at the creative side. To accomplish this, I work with two organizations. I work with Wachusett, which is a ski area in central Massachusetts, and Eastern Border, which is a snowboard and skateboard retailer in central Massachusetts and southern New Hampshire. So I'll tell you a little bit about Wachusett first. So my history is Wachusett. That's where I learned to snowboard when I was younger, where I had my first job as a snowboard instructor, and where I've made some of my best and lifelong friends. Now, a little history of Wachusett. They were founded in 1964 by the Crowley family, who owns Polar Beverages. And as you can see, this is one of their first maps, and if you look kind of on your right, there's, you know, one kind of smaller trail on the right, and then two or three more on the left. So that is their original map and flyer. Now, this is today's map. So you can see they've physically expanded. They just, you know, more trails. But now they can serve a maximum of 6,000 customers per day. And if you don't know, for the medium-small mountain that Wachusett is, that's a lot of people. They really only have 110 acres of skiable terrain, and putting 6,000 people through in one day is no small feat. So at Wachusett, I worked in two departments. I worked in the marketing office and the terrain parks. So I'll tell you a little about what I did. The marketing office, that's pretty self-explanatory. I worked mostly with the social media, creating different promotional posts and flyers. Here's one of the flyers I made for a snowboard event. And then the parks, for those who don't know, that's like, you know, if you've ever seen the X Games or the Olympics, rails, jumps, you know, where most snowboarders go. There was really day to day. So some days it would just be regular maintenance, making sure the snow is in good quality, making sure, you know, the rails are still in the snow and everything is in top shape. Other days would be setting up these awesome setups for different events that the mountain was holding. So what I saw in the marketing office, which was very disappointing, was that people were bored. And these were people, remind you, that were skiers and snowboarders, and that's how they originally got into this. But it seems like somewhere along the way, they kind of lost that, and it was this passionless work environment where you come in, you do what you have to do, and then you leave. Now in the parks, I found out how I imagined the parks before was that it was kind of, you know, the people who were working there, they kind of got to make whatever they wanted, and it was just, you know, up to them. But really it's actually has a lot to do with the financial side of the mountain and kind of a lot of restrictions having to do with insurance. We'll get into that a little bit later. So now Eastern Border. Eastern Border was founded in 1989, and they are so important because before then, it was really hard to get snowboard gear in southern New England, so a lot of the times you either had to order it, which, you know, computers back then, so that was difficult, from places like Colorado and Utah, where it was really happening. And so here is, you can see on your left, that this is an article from 1993 edition of Snowboarder magazine, just, you know, talking about what I talked about and how important they are. And then here is a 2003 photo sequence from a 2003 edition of Thrasher Skateboard magazine, and they're kind of like the biggest magazine in skateboarding right now. They're actually like part of pop culture. So this is one of Eastern Border's skaters, so that was really, really big for them. The first thing that I saw at Eastern Border is that it really is a family. It's people who love skateboarding and snowboarding. This is what they want to be talking about. This is what they want to be doing. And most importantly, there's always a dog. So that's nice. Somebody greet you. One of the biggest hardships facing Eastern Border right now is the retail industry versus the online industry. So I'm kind of the antithesis of what Mark was presenting on, where they're trying to show people why the retail industry is still relevant despite the availability and how it's cheap, you know, it is to buy stuff online. I'm sure most of you here have an Amazon Prime account, and you know how easy it is to just get anything within a day or two. So you can see there's a little statistic that in 2009, before online shopping was so big, Eastern Border had 5 shops, in central Massachusetts and southern New Hampshire, and around 100-plus employees. Go 9 years later into the future, and they're down to 2 shops, one in Worcester and one in Nashua, New Hampshire, and not even 15 employees. So that's, you know, around an 80% drop in what they own. That's huge. So here's kind of what I saw overall in each of these departments. So with Wachusett in the marketing, I saw not all the employees were motivated by their passion for skiing or riding. That it was actually often quite hierarchical. So what I imagined marketing, it was like a boardroom of people making the big decisions for the mountain, when really it's just kind of one guy at the top of everything, just kind of doing it because it's the easy option and not really interacting with the customer. So yeah, like I just said, it's less customer focus. So it's just kind of doing what they think is right, not really going out and finding what's going on the mountain and evolving with that. In the terrain parks, I found that people are very creative and very passionate, and this shows just talking. They want to talk about what you want in the parks and just kind of the good dialogue they have. Very customer focused, so like most of the people who worked in the terrain parks before I did, those were just like my friends who I rode with, and they said, hey, what do you think we can put in? We'll see what we can do. But what I learned is how limited they are and what they can put in. It's mostly from the insurance companies. So each week, our task was to go through the park, measure each feature, find the volume, record that, send that to the insurance companies, and then they would then decide how dangerous it was and give us a monthly quote on our insurance, you know, higher if it was more dangerous. So their priority, and they had a lot of pressure from upper management, was to keep that cost low. And so that was a big kind of a big block in their creativity. At Eastern Border, it's a very warm and friendly work environment. Even as a customer, it's not so much about selling people products, it's kind of about talking with them. It's very creative, and I had a lot of autonomy, so my boss often would say, all right, here's a bag, products, you know, because we do a lot of social media, we need to promote. Go around, just like locally, find cool places to take photos, we'll come back and see what worked, and we'll post what worked, and yeah, we'll go and figure out what didn't. And I had a really good time with that. I learned kind of where best to put different products, and kind of like how to show them. That was fun. The employees, most importantly, are motivated by their love for skateboarding and snowboarding, and to kind of maintain and create a culture of that. So the biggest thing missing with online is that there's no real people to talk to. And they want to draw people in by having, you know, creating a dialogue between themselves and the customers, and like talk about where you've been, you know, skateboarding recently, and like what products you like and what they should have in the store. So they're really, really interested kind of in the customer and, you know, expanding their network. Very customer focused, like I just said. So here's overall what I saw behind the curtain. That community and customer-oriented businesses are very good for customer and customer relationships, but they can have financial limitations. And we see that in the terrain parks, we see that at Eastern Border as well. And on that, the passion for whatever they're working on, whatever they're working with, it really shows, and it really kind of levels up the customer experience, and something you just don't get online. And what I took away from all of this was that I want to work in an environment where people love what they're doing and are so passionate about it that they are excited to come into work every day and excited to meet new customers. So I'd like to finish up with a quote from Bub, who is one of the original owners of Eastern Border. And this was in an interview where they were covering similar topics about the struggles of owning a retail store. So it sure doesn't help us pay the rent, but it always made us feel good. Thank you.